Stories of love and compassion, heartbreak and sorrow, forgiving and moving on, combined with heartfelt songs that will bring life to every letter sent in by wishers. Wish Date.
Dear Dr. Clark, in life, change happened really fast, and in many occasions, life is changed by 1 second. As for me, my life changed by a number of 1 second. The first 1 second of my life happened when I was 25 years old. I met Kate at a friend's party. She appeared at the door, seemingly followed by a shining bright light. She walked towards my direction and caught my attention instantly. She was wearing this white dress that made her face look so refreshing. It took just 1 second, and my life was changed by Kate. My life is never the same again. She is a beautiful, sweet girl who anybody can simply fall in love with. She stood out in the crowd and command a second look. Soon as I saw her, I knew that she will be someone I will love. That meeting was the beginning. In the ensuing days, I invited her for dates. I was happy that she agreed every time. While I haven't professed to her, I kind of getting indication that she might be feeling the same way. Me. I walk her home and did not utter any word on the way. I kept looking at her lovely face while we were walking, trying to evaluate what could she be feeling. She caught me one time glancing and our eyes met. She suddenly walked slowly and stopped. She looked at me quite sweetly and said, "I'm home. Thank you for the night." I did not realize that we were at her place already. I was not paying attention to anything but what she would have said in response. It felt like she was evasive and would not want to dwell on the topic. I waved goodbye to her and replied, "Good night, Kate. Sweet dreams." I started walking away. I turned around a number of times, and still, she's by the roadside. I don't know what to think of the situation. I felt that she has feelings for me too. But I did not receive any positive response from her, Dr. Clark. The non-response from Kate confused me. Does she love me back? Was I misled by my own thoughts? I kept asking myself as I walked to the bus stop. After a half-hour walk, I received a text message. I opened the message, and it says, "I love you too," from Kate.
On the world, and I was Every breath you take, every move you make, every bond you break, every step you take, I'll be watching you. Every single day, every word you say, every game you play, every night you stay, I'll be watching you. Oh, can't you
It was unfathomable, Dr. Clark, how 1 second can turn our lives around. We lived too many days and years, but we always remember all those 1 seconds that change each one of us. I wanted that moment to last. If there is a fountain of youth in Shangri-La, I wanted to build a fountain of blissful memories that never ends. A fairy tale not meant to perish. But those 1 seconds were made brief by time, but transported into forever by memories.
Just a small town girl living in. She took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere. Smell of wine and cheap perfume. Foreign smile.
After a couple of months of being married, Kate got pregnant and in time delivered a son. Another 1 second that transformed our lives. He was a precious, sweet child. We named him Carl.
So I lay my
He was simply adorable as he grew. Kate loved him more and more. He, of course, became the apple of her eyes. All her attention was focused on him. I started to notice the changes in how we relate to one another. The romance between us started to fade. We were moving with a pace that's neither too slow or too fast. Nothing significant to remember. All the moments became the hours and the years that simply passed by, insignificantly moving along with life, and it was becoming to be boring for me. Dr. Clark, it became countless seconds of insignificance. Life suddenly turned into a continuous clock-precise wheel that never missed a turn. A drive that simply took us to a destination without excitement nor fun.
Ko maintindihan ang nilalaman.
I devoted my time to work pretending to be happy. I was already resigned to the idea that it was the natural cycle of life. Excitement can't last forever. Fun is meant only for the young. I admit, Dr. Clark, whenever I felt burnt out, I took time to go to bars for some refreshing drinks. In the beginning, it was for me to unwind. It did not take long and it became a habit.
Sunshine.
I was going through my usual drink when suddenly, life's 1 second made its appearance from nowhere. With that mysterious second was the lady in red named Rika. She was captivating and easily captured my sleeping heart in an instant. Needless to say, a relationship developed and it continued for some time. My days became colorful and the hours became significant. Moments with her flashed me back to my youth and I was happy again. Another second that changed life completely. How I felt about her can't be explained. Rika was Kate of old. The lady in red gave me what I dreamt lasting forever. Every moment thrilling, every second breathtaking, and I don't want that to go away. I know Rika could make me happy forever, and so we planned to live together. I was to break up with Kate and leave her and Carl for Rika. While I know it will wreak havoc to my son and will anger Kate. My happiness emerged to be more important. Selfish? Yes, Dr. Clark. But I want to be happy. One night, while I was having dinner with Kate, I thought of breaking the bad news to her. I know it will hurt her, but I can no longer stay away from Rika. So I told her that I will move out of the house. At first, my words drew no reaction from Kate. I was not sure if she heard me. So I spoke louder and said, "Kate, I want to move out of the house." This time, she stared at me and softly asked me, "Why?" I did not want to say anything, but she repeated the question, "Why?" Annoyed, I told her that I am no longer in love with her and that I am having an affair with a girl. I can see her holding back her tears and maybe trying to understand what's happening. I did not want to, and maybe not ready to have a lengthy discussion. So I went up to the room and left Kate in the dining area.
Thank you.
Gusto nyo masakit?
Thank you.
Dr. Clark, that night, I could not sleep. I know I want to move, and that's what will make me happy. At the same time, I was worried about Kate and Carl. What will happen to them? So many thoughts and many more questions. The thoughts led to indiscriminate views that meant nothing. What is coming out so strongly, Dr. Clark, is that I am no longer in love with my wife. Another of life's 1 second that became my defining moment.
I got it.
The following day, I went to work and left Kate with a letter. In the letter, I mentioned about my intention to leave and move away with Rika. I could not say those in person, as my decision might change if I see her cry. She handed over a letter while tears falling down her cheek.
Guys, marapang ka naman dyan, guys. Maraming salamat po. Puno silent sanctuary. Maraming salamat sa Ligo Panay concert. Kapag-kita sa amin.
The first of the 30 days was clumsy. I struggled to act like I was happy with my wife. For my son, I tried hard to make it appear like we were sweet. What's even strange is that Kate requested for me to carry her as we retire in the room in front of our son. So I was forced to do so, and it made me uncomfortable. While I held her in my arms, she softly whispered, "Don't tell our son about our agreement." and I nodded. The following day, it's the same ritual, and with anticipation, it did not feel awkward. As she leaned on my chest while carrying her, I smelled the fragrance in her body, and it dawned on me that I have not been paying attention to Kate. I realized that she has gotten old. Some fine lines started to become evident in her face. And for a moment, I felt guilty about what I have done with her.
Colors and pure.
On the fifth day, I felt some intimacy returning. I suddenly was taken back in the days of old. Even as we pretend, I would sleep through to see Rika. I felt different with Rika now, compared to days before I told Kate about my plan. I can't pinpoint what changed, and I can't identify how I feel anymore.
Hanggang may musika ako tinataglay, kita'y iniibig. Iliwag mo sanang isipin, ikaw ay aking lilisanin. Di ko magagawang lumayo sa iyong malaman mo kung gano'ng kita kamahal. Hanggang ang diwa ko'y tanging sa'yo laan, mamahalin kailanman. Hanggang pag-ibig ko, hanggang walang hanggan, tanging ikaw lamang. Hanggang may himig pa ko narinig dito sa
kanta tayo sa Solaire!
Iniwag mo sanang isipin, ikaw ay aking
tangi. Tangi. Tangi.
Days passed, and the intimacy between Kate and I grew each passing day. It started to feel similar to when we just got married. Kate looks happy with each day. One day, she asked me to hold her tight, and I obliged. Carl was around and was evidently happy with what he is seeing. Kate asked Carl to get closer. As he moved closer to us, I turned my face away. I don't want my reaction to betray me. I'm starting to doubt if I were doing the right thing if I leave them. On the 30th day, I pensively assess how I feel. I should be happy as I am now free to move away with Rika. I wondered why I am not. It dawned on me that I can't leave my family. I have come to realize how much I love Kate still. At that moment, I knew what I needed to do. I rushed out and went to Rika. When we were talking, I told Rika that I can't be with her. I still love Kate, and I can't leave my family.
Goodbye.
After those words, I left and did not look back. I ran back to the house quickly. I wanted to tell Kate about my decision and how much more I love her now.
Mga kaibigan, kayo ba naniniwala pa kayo sa forever? Naniniwala pa ba kayo sa magpakailanman? Pwes, makinig kayo. Di magwawakas hanggang sa dulo ng mundo. Ang kalinga ko'y asahan mo. Kahit pa anong landas ay tatahakin ko upang tayo'y di magkalayo. Sana'y laging kapiling, yan ang aking dalangin.
Alam niyo ba to?
Magpakailanman magbabago ang sinisigaw nitong aking puso, magpakailanman, magpakailanman.
May mga cellphone ba kayo? Labas nyo nga, i-flashlight nyo naman oh.
kinakailangan mo, narito ako, handang dumamay sa iyong lungkot. Habang buhay ay hinding-hindi maglalaho, ang himig natin ay awitin ko. Sana ay pakinggan, tayo ay walang hanggan. Magpakailanman, hindi magbabago ang sinisigaw nitong aking puso. Na ika'y kapiling ko ang aking buhay, ang aking buhay sa'yo. Kailanman di magmamaliw ang apoy sa puso ko. Habang may buhay, hanggat ang dugo ko ay dumadaloy sa'yo lamang, ang aking buhay, ang aking buhay sa'yo. Ang maganda siguro makita ngayon eh, kanina nangalay ang kilikili ninyo dahil sa inyong mga cellphones. Mas mabigat pag may cellphone eh. Kamay na lang, itaas natin ang ating mga kamay. Iwagayway. At kung tayo'y magwawalay, ako'y mabibigo, di na nanaisin pa ituloy ang buhay ko habang may buhay. Habang may buhay, ang hindi magtaas ng kamay, mabaho na ang kilikili. Ibig sabihin, sa'yo lamang ialay ang aking buhay, ang aking buhay sa'yo. Pwede na ibaba para makapahinga naman ang inyo. Baka kulani pa kayo. Ako pa sisihin ninyo eh. Okay lang. Okay lang.
Ibig ko malaman mo hanggang sa dulo ng mundo ang pangarap ko'y sa'yo.
When I finally got home, I hurriedly looked for Kate and I found her with Carl. They were playing and was a picture of perfect happiness. I went close to them and held them tight. I asked both to dress up and we will go out to celebrate. Carl asked, "What's the reason for the celebration?" I said, "We celebrate life, and that I am thankful that we are happily living together." We dine in one of the best restaurants, and I have not seen Kate happier.
But will you?
I love you, Kate. I'm sorry for everything.
I know. I love you the same.
Thank you.
Hindi pa pangako mo nung una, tiwala'y iingatan. Baka naman sa susunod na habang buhay.
It was the last time I saw them. In a second, they were gone. We met a vehicular accident. A truck ran us over. In the accident, Kate and Carl perished. 5 years have passed since. I still remember Kate and Carl every second in the last 5 years. Imagine, Dr. Clark, how painful and tragic that accident was. I almost lost my mind afterwards. I kept blaming myself for what happened, and I really don't know how to move on. I never did, and I don't know if I will. I reflected and realized my life has been defined by meaningful seconds. All those 1 seconds that changed lives. From that second I met Kate to the second I saw my wife and son breathless. Dr. Clark, thank you for reading my letter. Writing the story made it fresh again in my mind. I struggle to move on, and I am uncertain if I will be able to recover from the tragedy. Sincerely, Joseph.
Thank you. Thank you. po natin lahat ng buong buo na konsyerto mo. Thank you, Wish.
Thank you. Date would like to thank Solaire Resort, our official venue partner for tonight's event, Best House of Chicken, Daniel's Coffee, it's not my coffee if it's not Daniel's, Salute, EFS Apparel, style is nothing, Marcid Blue, purified drinking water, ERC Travel Services, KDR Adventure Camp, KDR Studios and Productions Incorporated, Wiseman Insurance Agency, KDR Distribution and Marketing, Morong Star Hotel and Resort, Smallville Dive Center and Resort, JCAS Catering Services and Events Management, Hideout by Fusion, Food Trip Hangouts, our media partners, Manila Bulletin, Bitchworks Incorporated, Globaltronics, Radio La Verdad 1350, UNTV News and Rescue, and Wish 107.5.
Kaya let's go get ready na, baka maiwan ka. Tara na, habutin ang pamilya. Tara na, yayain ang barkada. Sulat ang pangalan, sasarap baka malimutan. The best ang chicken at the best house of chicken.
Coffee make it too. The thrill. Ride in the extreme. Feel the rush. Live the excitement. Feed the adventure in you. Only here at KDR Adventure Camp. Let's get it done.